Knowledge is power. Make an impact by learning more, or hire us to do it for you. Let us focus on what we do best so you can stay focused on what you do best. Find all of our options under services, one-to-one training, subscription-based training, or accounting and business consulting. Handle multiple AMEX accounts and payments in QuickBooks Online. First of all, what am I talking about? Here's what I'm talking about. I encounter this a lot, actually, where clients have more than two AMEX accounts, three, sometimes more. They've got a gold account, a plum account, and maybe even a black card, right? And where it gets tricky on the bookkeeping side is when we're downloading the banking and we see the payments come out being made towards these American Express accounts. The descriptions don't usually have the account number in them. They'll have numbers, reference numbers, and other sorts of things. But the bottom line is there's no easy way to tell which card is being paid from any given payment. So it might look something exactly like what you're seeing here on my screen, where I have three different American Express payments, each to a different account. And it, you know, QuickBooks is trying to figure out where to put it, but it doesn't know. So I've got to figure out where to put it. I've got to add each transaction and choose the correct AMEX account. Now, I could stop and log in to each of the client's three AMEX accounts and find the payment and match the amount so I know for sure which card it went to. But that's really going to slow me down, especially when I have, you know, 150 transactions in here and I'm trying to get the banking done quickly, right? So I'd rather find a way to park it until I know that as part of some other process that I'm going to do anyway, I will run across that payment. And that's exactly what I described for you in the write-up here. That's going to happen because eventually I'm going to download the banking for the Amex cards. Or at the very latest, when I go to reconcile the credit card accounts, I'm going to see the exact amounts and dates of any payments that were made. Bottom line, I need my balance sheet accurate, but I don't want to have to, I don't want this to slow me down. Everything we do at Nerd Enterprises is on the basis of extreme efficiency, right? And stopping to log into three Amex accounts while I'm trying to do the banking for my Wells Fargo account is going to slow me down. It's too slow. So here's what we do. In the chart of accounts, as soon as I see that we have a situation like this where there's, you know, more than two accounts, I create a parent category in the credit card section called Amex cards. And then I put each of the three Amex accounts and I put an Amex payment clearing. The Amex parent payment clearing, notice as a subaccount of these, lets me quickly park these payments there. And because I set them up as subaccounts, I've got one section which will give me the correct total liability in terms of the balance due across all of the Amex accounts. So let's just quickly put in Amex payment clearing. Plus, for purposes of setting rules now, I can say one rule. Anytime there's Amex in there, stick it in the payments clearing account, right? Because these two now are done in two more clicks. So that makes it easy. And then let's run a report. I want to look at my balance sheet. And now we can see what this looks like. So I have $90,000 in payments here. I have the other accounts, right? And now let's say I went in and I figured out which goes where. The $50,000 payment went here, right? So I'm going to go in here. In fact, let's duplicate this. I love duplicating my tabs in QuickBooks Online. It's so much fun. I'm going to click into the payment clearing. We're going to take the $50,000. And the reason I like to duplicate this is so I don't lose my place. I can still look back here on my balance sheet and say, yeah, the $50,000 went to the black card. So instead of to Amex payment clearing, and this was a point, I made a big point about this in the write-up. I don't do like a journal entry to move the amount out of clearing. In other words, I'm not going to leave it in the clearing. I actually just edit the account. I don't know why it's asking me to do that. Amex black card, that's what I want. Okay, save and close. So I don't journal entry. I don't do a journal entry to move it. I just actually edit the transactions. Now the $25,000 payment goes to the gold. So that gets changed to Amex gold. Save and close. One left, and that's going to the plum. I don't know why this one went in as expense and the others as transfers. I don't really care that much at this point. Nope. There it is. And save and close. And that fixes it. And now when I go back to my balance sheet, same net amount, right? All I did was take those payments out of payment clearing and spread them out into the appropriate cards. But again, the point is I do that when I'm in a process that I'm going to do anyway, such as that later on downloading the bank fees for the credit card, which would, of course, be here. Or as I said earlier, I'll say it again, or when I'm reconciling the credit card account. That is for sure when I'll be looking right at the payments and I can see by the exact amount. I used even numbers here for the sake of illustration. Normally, they're going to be specific amounts, especially if we're paying the balances off in full. Then it just becomes very easy to track. For some reason my client has paid the exact same amount to two different cards, if they're both paid on the same day, it doesn't really matter which one I code where. If they're on different dates, then you just have to match it up by date. So the one with the date that's earlier in the bank account goes to the Amex card with the credit on the earlier date. And that's how you do it, just to create the best possible audit trail for any of this. At the end of the day, it doesn't matter if it's the right amount, it's the right amount. That's my story, and I'm sticking to it, handling multiple Amex accounts and payments in QuickBooks Online. As always, I hope you learned something here and had some fun along the way. I hope you're having an absolutely fantastic day, and I look forward to seeing you on the web.